Hello and welcome to the session of biochemistry. This is Suresh Kumar Paswan, assistant professor in GSITS Indore. Today we are going to discuss on the topic of phenylalanine and tyrosine metabolism and their disorders. So this is a very important topic in biochemistry because these two compounds, this phenylalanine and tyrosine, these are the aromatic amino acids and they are responsible for a lot of their metabolic products, which are like dopamine. It is norepinephrine, melatonin, melanin, 5-hydroxytryptophan. So these we can say serotonin. So these are their metabolic compounds, and these are they play a very significant role in your proper functioning of your body. So today we are going to discuss phenylalanine tyrosine metabolism and their disorder. So talking about the synthesis of tyrosine, or we will say the metabolism of phenylalanine. So talking about this phenylalanine, it gets converted into tyrosine. Here what is happening here in the two oxygen groups are involved in the presence of phenylalanine the enzyme which is responsible for this is phenylalanine hydroxylase. So what is happening here, we are having NADPH and H. What is it is doing, it is converting this two coenzymes, this dihydroxybiotrin to tetrahydrobiotrin. So what is happening, this NADPH, it will involve and it will give two hydrogen ion, and again here also NADPH is required. So what is happening, this two hydrogen, total four hydrogen ions are involved. Two hydrogen ion, it will go over here and it will, this tetrahydrobiotrin, it is getting converted into dihydroxyhydrobiotrin. So here one oxygen, it will get attached to this particular portion, and two hydrogen ion will attach and it will form water molecule, and the product what we are getting is tyrosine. This is a very important product. In the next step, this tyrosine, it is getting converted to hydroxyphenyl pyruvate. So in this step, what is happening, transamination process taking place in the presence of PLP. This thing already we discussed about in discussing amino acid metabolism. The tyrosine transamination process, aminase enzyme is involved, and here this keto alpha keto glutarate is converted into glutamate. So what is happening there, this keto group, it will transfer at this portion, and this amino group, it will transfer to the glutamate. So here what is happening, the transfer of groups is happening in pyruvate enzyme, this PLP, and what is happening, what we are getting is para-hydroxyphenyl pyruvate, and this para-hydroxyphenyl pyruvate, in the presence of para-hydroxyphenyl pyruvate dioxygenase enzyme, it is converting into homogenate, and this homogenate, here what is happening, this ascorbate, it will go through the process of decarboxylation process, and what is happening here, one oxygen, CO2 has been removed, water has been removed. Okay, in the next step, this homogenate, it gets oxidized in presence of oxygen, and the cleavage will be there at this particular portion. So what you are getting, 4-methylacetoacetate. And this 4-methylacetoacetate, converts into 4-fumarylacetoacetate. The structure are same. So here the enzyme which is responsible is isomerase enzyme, methylacetoacetate isomerase. So what is happening here, CO2 group, it is shifting to the other portion. So what we are getting is 4-fumarylacetoacetate. And this 4-fumarylacetoacetate, it hydrolyzes by the enzyme fumarylacetoacetate, and it get converted into fumarate and acetoacetate. This fumarate is a very important compound, and acetoacetate is also a very important compound. This will go to the process of TCA cycle and gluconeogenesis, in the synthesis of glucose. So glucose will form by fumarate, and the acetoacetate, it will form, will go to the into the formation of lipids by process of ketogenesis. So Another one, like this tyrosine, this is converted into very important compounds like your dopamine, norepinephrine, and epinephrine. And here, melanin polymer plaques. So the tyrosine, it is a very important compound, and it gets converted to dihydroxyphenylalanine in presence of tyrosine hydrolase. And this dihydroxyphenylalanine, again it gets converted into, it goes through the process of decarboxylation. And what's happening here, this CO2 will be removed from this portion. Okay, so here what we are getting, a very important compound, that is dopamine. It is a neurotransmitter residing in your brain, and it is responsible for all your daily activities. And if there is depletion of this particular compound dopamine, so what will happen, what the disease what we are going to get is, that is Parkinsonism disease. And this dopamine, it will get converted into norepinephrine and epinephrine in the presence of dopamine beta hydroxylase, and this oxygen it will take, will be required. And what is happening here, this OH will be attached. Okay, so here what you are getting, we are getting norepinephrine. And this norepinephrine, one methyl group will be attached at this particular portion. Okay, so here adenosyl methionine, it is getting converted to adenosyl homocysteine in the presence of phenyl ethanolamine and methyl transferase enzyme. So one methyl group has been attached in this particular portion in the epinephrine. So next one is this dihydroxyphenylalanine, it will get in the presence of tyrosinase enzyme. What will happen? We have this two hydrogen molecule, it will be removed in the presence of oxygen, and we are getting dopaquinone. And dopaquinone, by non-enzymatic method, it gets converted into leukodopachrome, and this leukodopachrome, it will get converted into 5,6-dihydroxyindole. This particular group will be removed, and this dihydroxyindole will get converted to indole 5,6-quinone. Here H group will be removed, and by series of reaction it will get converted to melanochrome, and this melanochrome it will get converted into melanin black. And here again dopaquinone in the presence of cysteine, it will, this cysteine molecule will attach over here, and by the series of reaction it is getting converted into melanin black. So this melanin is a very important compound. This is responsible for the color of your skin, and the depletion it will may leads to albinism. We'll discuss later on. So here I've written this process, summarize this process. This phenylalanine, it is getting converted into tyrosine, and tyrosine it is then converted into parahydroxyphenyl pyruvate, into homogensate, and homogensate into malyl acetate, and 4-fumaryl acetoacetate. So here we are having these enzymes which are responsible for all the process. Let us see if there is depletion of this enzyme, what will happen. So when there is depletion of this enzyme, like phenylalanine, phenylketonuria is there, tyrosine and tyrosine transaminase enzyme, it is responsible for tyrosinemia 2, and parahydroxyphenyl pyruvate dioxygenase enzyme, it is responsible for neonatal transaminemia, and homogensate, it is responsible oxidase is responsible for alpha keto, the alpha ketonuria, and malyl acetoacetate isomerase and fumaryl acetoacetate hydrolase is responsible for tyrosinemia 1. Let us see one by one. So this phenylalanine hydroxylase enzyme, if it is depleted, generally it is a Wolff deficiency, and at this portion the blockage of the synthesis of the further molecule is there. So phenylalanine, if it is not getting converted into tyrosine, there are lot of disorders may take place, and you will get so what will happen in that case, if this process is not moving on, so it will go through the other process, and it will start producing phenyl pyruvate, phenyl acetate, phenyl glutamine, and this will affect the it will give effect on the CNS, because the process of tyrosine is been stopped, and further like melanin is been stopped, dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, then 5-HT is there, serotonin, all those things has been stopped. So the child which will get birth, it may have a mental retardation, it will fail to walk, talk, growth, seizure, tryptophan, tyrosine, all these things has been stopped, serotonin, that is 5-HT has been, the synthesis has been stopped. So most of the compound they had been stopped, so that may affect the mental growth of the child. So and it will like effect on pigmentation, like melanin production has been stopped, so the child will get albinism. And the treatment is like what we are going to do. So we want this tyrosine, so and here the production of this particular compounds are more. So what we have to do, we have to reduce this phenylalanine content and we have to increase the tyrosine content. So low phenylalanine food is required and tyrosine content of food should be increased. And another thing, like treatments had can be given by 5-HT, dopamine can give restore serotonin and catecholamine. Next one is, if the tyrosine transaminase enzyme has been blocked, so further the steps will be blocked. So what we are going to get, we are going to get tyrosinemia, and there will be excess production of para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate, para-hydroxyphenylacetate, and N-acetyl tyrosine and tyramine. The effect will be like skin dermatitis may take place, eye lesion, rarely mental retardation may take place, because tyrosine is there. So it may go through the pathway of dopamine synthesis and other things, but the thing is like this process has been stopped. So the treatment can be given by giving the further things, and phenylalanine can be the doses of tyrosine and phenylalanine can be reduced. So next one is if there is blockage of this para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate dioxygenase enzyme, so this process will be stopped and we will get a new natal tyrosinemia, but this can be treated because this ascorbic acid we can give and we can treat this disease. Another one is homogenate oxidase. If this depletion of this enzyme is there, then alpha captonuria will be there, and like polyphenol oxidase, homogenate will convert to benzopinonacetate, and this will convert to alpha L-captone, and this L-captone is a brown color product or dark brown color product, and the urine you will get is black or brown urine. So from that you can identify that this particular disease is there, alpha captonuria. Other one is if we are having a shortage of melanin acetoacetate isomerase or phenyl acetoacetate hydrolase, so what we are going to get, we are going to get tyrosinemia 1, and it effect is like we are not going to get the fumarate synthesis and acetoacetate. So the infant exhibit diarrhea, vomiting, cabbage like odor. The treatment is the diet with low tyrosine, phenylalanine and methionine can be given. So next is disorder of albinism. So another one, albinism, like if the lack of tyrosinase enzyme is there, or decrease in melanosomes of melanocytes are there, or impairment in melanin polymerization is there, or lack of protein matrix in melanosomes are there, or limitation in substrate of availability, or limitation of tyrosinase enzyme. So each and everything is linked with the this particular enzyme, that is tyrosinase enzyme. Or so what is happening, the process of synthesis of melanin is stopped, so this particular albinism or albino kind of things is there. So white screen, cornea disorders will be there, that pupil disorders will be there. So the child birth will take place, that will have a albinism. So these are all I have taken from Satyanarayana and Chakkarpani. Thank you everybody. This is my email ID and my phone number. You can contact me at this particular email ID. I hope I made some sense and you also have enjoyed the video. Thank you.